This week on Behind the Laughter, the story of the Simpsons Christmas cards. They were newlyweds living in Italy, a first Christmas away from home. How could the Simpson family possibly imagine what they had started with one harmless Christmas picture to send home to their family and friends?
We were just married, and that picture, I thought it was crazy, but I just went along with it.
There was jet setting, partying, everything in excess.
We were young and foolish. I was cocky. I thought we could get away with anything. We actually sent out a different picture to a lot of our closer relatives. So let me tell you, if you got a different picture than the one you're about to see, that's because we didn't think you could handle it at the time.
Next came Denmark. A house in the country, a little one on the way.
We were living in Denmark, and we hadn't told many people that I was pregnant, so we thought it'd be a fun way of spreading the news.
What can I say? I've always been into body painting.
Two Christmases and two pictures sending buzz throughout the internet. Number three would have to be big. Only a castle setting in England would do.
15 Christmas songs in a picture? What is he thinking about?
Oh, this one was exciting because my parents were visiting from Canada. We were living in Sheffield, England. And we'd come up with this idea to try to hide 15 Christmas songs in a picture.
Frosty the Snowman.
Jingle bell rock.
Jingle bell, jingle bell.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
The next year, Copenhagen came calling and family came to visit.
We were in Tivoli Gardens, right in the center of Copenhagen. And for the life of me, I cannot find someone to take this picture. There we are, all scattered out through the park. You got to try to find the different Simpsons with their hats on. Once again, my parents were visiting. And finally, I found this wonderful Danish guy, and we made him stand there for 15 minutes taking picture after picture.
By now, the buzz had reached epic proportions. The Simpsons were burnt out and creatively spent.
I wasn't saying anything at the time, but I was thinking, this is the stupidest thing we've ever done.
My daddy's weird.
I gotta be honest. It looked a lot better in my mind's eye. I thought this was gonna be something that was pretty cool. Us all in pictures, all wrapped up. What do you want under the tree for Christmas? Didn't work out that way. And let's just forget that one ever happened.
A hint of inspiration in March 2008 led to the Simpson family getting back on track.
This was our most popular picture up until this point, but thank God he didn't make me stand by the fireplace.
Have you ever seen those cartoons where they're trying to find different things that are not the same from each picture? Well, that was the idea for our next Christmas card. I wanted Tara to be the one posing at the fireplace.
With momentum on their side and the talk of the town, nobody could have predicted what happened next.
We thought last year's Christmas card was popular. This one took it to a whole new level.
In our world of plenty.
It must have been December 10th or 11th, and on came the song.
Raise it.
Expectations were huge. The bar was raised. How could they possibly please everyone?
This is Tara's favorite TV show. I'm not a big fan, but I thought I'd go with it.
I think you had to watch the show Glee for this one to know exactly what we were trying to get at, especially with Jagger not knowing that we were trying to make him look like Puckerman.
Next year, inspiration comes back in the form of a rock legend.
Ding dong, wake up!
Ever since we have started this, I've been skeptical for every single one. But the next one, I couldn't help but doubt.
The Christmas before, we had a wild night on Christmas Eve. We stayed up way too late. We probably had a little bit too much to drink. Sure enough, the kids come running in at 6 a.m. And I tell you what, we felt great. It was Christmas morning. There was no hangover. And from there, the song got into my head. There ain't no hangover Christmas morning. Tara's asleep and I'm still snoring. And the rest is history.
Wake up in the morning and raise my weary head. Hey, what's Bon Jovi doing sleeping in my bed? What happened last night? Can't seem to remember. Lord knows it was the 24th of December. Christmas morning, Tara's asleep and I'm still snoring. Avery's on the bed and Jagger is roaring. Oh, there ain't no hangover on Christmas morning. Jump down the stairs, what do I see? Looks like Santa's been to our tree. Before long I've regained my swagger. Pretty soon I'll be moving like Jagger. Oh, there ain't no hangover Christmas morning. Clouds have lifted and now I'm soaring. Fill it up again and just start pouring. Oh, there ain't no hangover Christmas morning.
Avery, what do you think we should do next year?
Next year? What about this year?